Hello everyone, my name is Anchen Li. I come from College of Computer Science and Technology, Jilin University. I'm glad to present our work. This is a joint work with University of Technology, Sydney. In this paper, we propose a framework named Hypercomplex Graph Collaborative Filtering, which utilizes hypercomplex algebras and graph convolutional technology for collaborative filtering tasks. Collaborative filtering has become one of the dominant technology used in recommendation. Learning high-quality user and item representation forms the crux of collaborative filtering. Most models learn representation in the real number system, ignoring the great potential for other algebra systems. Recently, there is a surge in studying the recommendation models in hypercomplex spaces. In mathematics, hypercomplex algebra is defined as distributed algebra. Compared with traditional real-value representation, hypercomplex representations consist of real and hyperimaginary components. An n-dimensional hypercomplex number has a representation in the following form. Here, x are real numbers called the components, and elements I are called hyperimaginary units. Recently, researchers proposed diverse hypercomplex recommender, which boosts the performance. However, we argue that existing hypercomplex approaches fall short in two aspects. First, high-dimensional hypercomplex algebras are underexploited. Current methods are designed for specific and low-dimensional hypercomplex representation learning. However, there exist high-dimensional numbers in hypercomplex algebra families. As shown in Figure 1, high-dimensional hypercomplex numbers have more components. Intuitively, these high-dimensional ones are more expressive, while they are underexploited by the existing method. Second, high-order user-item relationships are not captured. Recent study on adopting graph convolutional technology in recommendation have shown the importance of modeling high-order user-item relations. Nevertheless, most hypercomplex recommenders exploit variants of metric factorization framework, which ignores such high-order user-item information. Motivated by the aforementioned gaps in this paper, we study the high-dimensional hypercomplex algebra for CF by utilizing GCN technologies. Indeed, it is a non-trivial task, since the mathematical operations in hypercomplex algebras are different from those in the real number system. Most well-established real-value GCN recommender cannot be directly applied to the hypercomplex spaces. In addition, with the increase of the hypercomplex algebra dimension, mathematical operations become more complex. How can we diverse a hypercomplex GCN model in an elegant way is the other challenge. To solve the above challenges, we introduce Cayley-Dixon construction to design our framework. Cayley-Dixon algebra is a sequence of hypercomplex algebras obtained from the real numbers by the Cayley-Dixon construction. Higher dimensional algebras are obtained by doubling the previous smaller ones in the Cayley-Dixon construction. Specifically, such a construction procedure is defined as follows. The mathematical operations for Cayley-Dixon algebra are defined recursively. Several widely utilized operations for Cayley-Dixon algebras are introduced as follows. Based on this form of mathematical operations, we can use the low-dimensional algebra operation to study the high-dimensional ones recursively. We will use these operations of Cayley-Dixon algebras to design our method HCGCF. We focus on the collaborative filtering task with implicit feedback. The following figure illustrates our HCGCF architecture. There are three parts in HCGCF. The first part is the embedding layer. Such layer initialize embeddings for user and items in the hypercomplex space. The second part is the hypercomplex graph convolutional layer. Such layers learn the hypercomplex embeddings by exploiting the high-order user-item relationship. The third part is the prediction layer. Such layers generate the preference score of a user-item pair based on the refined embeddings. We will detail each part in the following. We first introduce the embedding layer. The embedding layer encodes users and items with Cayley-Dixon representation. Specifically, given a user-item pair, user and item embedding are formulated according to the definition of Cayley-Dixon construction as follows. We then introduce the aggregation layer. The aggregation layer consists of a linear aggregator and an interaction aggregator. The linear aggregator models a summary of the neighborhood. In addition, since the feature interaction is important for recommendation, we design an interaction aggregator to capture neighbor feature interactions. Finally, we use a function f to combine the representation from these two aggregators. For the linear aggregator, it takes the summation of the neighbors' hypercomplex representations to describe the neighborhood information. The process is defined as follows. We use the accumulation of the hypercomplex addition for the Cayley-Dixon algebras. Feature interaction are also very important signals. Therefore, we design an interaction aggregator to capture such information by applying the hypercomplex multiplication as follows. Different from the multiplication in the real number system, the hypercomplex multiplication captures latent interdependency between all the components, which encourage a more compact interaction of the neighborhood. To combine the two aggregation, we adopt a linear combination scheme. Here, omega is a trade-off factor in function f. Finally, we introduce the prediction layer. The prediction layer is defined as follows. After aggregation, we utilize the holistic connection to combine the embeddings obtained at each layer at users and items' final representation as follows. By doing so, we consider different semantics in different layers to enrich the initial embeddings with the aggregation layer. To predict the preference score, we first use the hypercomplex multiplication to model the interaction between the user and item representations, and then feed the interaction representation into a function k, which transforms the hypercomplex embedding to real values. To learn the model parameters, we utilize the cross-entropy loss, where lRank measures the recommendation loss, and the second term is the regularization term. In the following, we introduce the experiment part. We conduct experiments with three datasets corresponding to book, movie, and music recommendation, respectively. We consider two applications to evaluate the model performance. The first is the click-through rate prediction task. Area and the curve and the currency are adopted as the evaluation metrics. The second is the top K recommendation. Precision and the recall are utilized as the evaluation metrics. To verify our method, we compare it with the following three group baselines covering the classical models, the graph-based models, and the hypercomplex value models. To exploit the high-dimensional hypercomplex algebras, we implement 5 instances in HCGCF based on 5 Cayley-Dixon algebras. Since the Cayley-Dixon representation has multiple components, we fix the representation size as 64 for HCGCF. The following table shows the performance of all models. From the result, we found that among all methods, HCGCF achieved strongly competitive performance in CTR prediction and top K recommendation. For different HCGCF instances, we found that increasing hypercomplex algebra dimension initially can enhance the performance. These results show that high-dimensional hypercomplex algebras improve the performance within a certain dimensional range. However, the performance drops when the dimensional further increases. One possible reason is that since we fix the same model size for all instances, there is a trade-off between the algebra dimension and the component embedding size. Too small embedding size means weak representation learning ability of the component, which may reduce the performance. Next, we study the effect of three hyperparameters, including layer size, component embedding size, and the trade-off factor. For the layer size, we observe that when layer size increases from 0 to 1, the performance increases quickly for most HCGCF instances, verifying the importance of considering user-atom relationships. The result also shows that high-dimensional hypercomplex algebra instances can achieve good performance without designing multi-layer structures compared with the low-dimensional ones. For the component embedding size, we observe that increasing embedding size generally boosts the performance, since a large embedding size can encode more information, while a too large embedding size increases the model size. Therefore, we need to find a proper size to balance the trade-off between the performance and the storage space. For the trade-off factor, the performance increases when factor is turned from 0 to the optimal value and then drops down, indicating linear and interaction aggregators complement each other. Finally, we conduct experiments for embedding visualization. To conduct an assessment of the learned embeddings, we utilize the TSNE to project the embeddings into a two-dimensional space. The following figure shows the visualization of the embeddings of the real-value method LightGCN and 5 HCGCF instances on the book design. We randomly select 3,000 user atom pairs from the test set. The red node and the blue node represent users and items. From the figure, we found that, compared with LightGCN, our HCGCF shows a better layout. In addition, we found that high-dimensional algebras provide an inductive bias for reflecting the asymmetrical user-item relations. To summary, our contribution in this paper are highlighted as follows. We propose HCGCF to study high-dimensional hypercomplex algebras and high-order user-item relations in recommendation. We provide an elegant approach that study high-dimensional hypercomplex spaces by using Cayley-Dixon construction. Experiment result on 3 real-world datasets prove the efficiency of our HCGCF over several state-of-art baselines. We believe the insight in this study and the promising result are enlightening for other future works to exploit the hypercomplex space in solving recommendation problems. The references used in this presentation are listed as follows. That is all my presentation. Thank you.